Here's a great one. How are we going to sum across sheets when the rows are not lined up? Or which Excel functions really work with 3D references? Great question this morning from Rebaz on a video called Sum Across Worksheets. Hello, sir. If we have different cell in different sheet, how can I sum? All right, so back in 1984, it was simple. There was Andy through Nan. They were in the same order, and we were going to spear through the sheets, apple, banana, cherry, dill. But now, since each sheet is sorted high to low by sales, we can't count on the fact that Andy is always going to be in A2. He's going to be in a different place each time. All right, so we're going to start out with just the simplest 3D formula here. So I want to equal sum. And I want to sum everything from apple to fig. So watch how cool this is. I click on apple, but I don't click on anything. And then I shift click on the fig sheet and then select the cells that I want. Close paren and press enter. And that formula spears through and grabs everything from B2 to B15 on every sheet from apple to fig. Simple enough, right? So then I'm thinking, all right, how are we going to be able to do this where we don't know where Andy is on each sheet? And my first thought, of course, is XLOOKUP, right? So a simple little XLOOKUP, go look for Andy on the apple sheet, return the revenue from the corresponding row in column B. That works great. But then when I try and make XLOOKUP work from apple to fig, and send the whole thing into the sum function, that does not work. So XLOOKUP is not working with 3D references. Then I thought, okay, how about filter? Filter is kind of a new formula. You know, what if we filter on the apple sheet to get everything where the column A is equal to Andy? And that works great for one sheet, but when I try and do it for all of the sheets, it fails. SUMIFS, I mean that, boy, this is almost a no-brainer. This one should really work. Go sum up everything in column B on apple, where column A is equal to C4, right? And when I tried to make that into a 3D reference, everything from apple to fig, I get a value error. So this is kind of driving me crazy now. Like what, you know, what functions really work with 3D references? And I remember one of the MVP summits, Joe McDade, TEXTJOIN had just come out, and he was really proud of the fact. He said, hey, yeah, TEXTJOIN is gonna work with a 3D reference. So I knew that is possible for TEXTJOIN to work with a 3D reference. So check this out. TEXTJOIN, the delimiter is going to be a pipe because I figured there wouldn't be a pipe in the data. Ignore empty, I said false. And then I want everything from apple to fig, A2 to A15, right? And what it does is it gives me one huge long string of every name on every sheet. And so it's Jared I. Kelly. Jared I. Kelly, yeah, see, it's doing it. And now, thankfully, we're at the point where we have text split. So I can take the text split of the text join and split it out. This is the column delimiter, I left that blank, into a row, right? So now I have a way that I can take all of the data from all of those sheets, put it into one very long string, and then unwind that right here into this sheet with text split. All right, so you know, using the same concept we just did, I get a list of all the names, and then I get a list of all of the sales amounts. So I'm bringing everything from the other sheets into this sheet, the names, and then the amounts. Right, here's a list of our people arranged alphabetically, and if we can just reuse those helper arrays, I ended up using SUMPRODUCT here, which is funny. Historically, I was always the last person to use SUMPRODUCT, but it's definitely going to work in this case. So we're going to go look at every single item in the C reference and see if it's equal to Andy. That's either going to be true or false. And when we multiply a true or false by the revenue in the D6 array, the trues are going to change to 1 and the falses change to 0. So it ends up, you know, basically being like a sum if almost, and it gets our total. So we have one formula there. We have to copy it down. That's reusing the helper arrays. If you didn't want to have the helper arrays exposed here, then you could actually put those helper arrays right inside. So the sum product, here's our first parenthesis. So we go basically use text join to put everything together from column A and then split it back out and see if it's equal to Andy. And then multiply that by all of the revenue. We put it all together with text join and then split it back out. I also took a look at using let. Is this any simpler? I don't think it's much simpler. I don't know. I guess that's your call. And then I started to think, okay, you know, what else could make this easier? I've just done a whole bunch of episodes on Python. Is there some way to store that first formula, that first helper array in a Python object? But unfortunately, it looks like the Excel function only points to a reference. We can't put a formula inside of there. So building all this out with Python just gives me a whole bunch of Python errors. And then the other thing I thought of, you know, all right, so Joe McDade made a big deal about text join being able to work with 3D references. What else has Joe given us? What's in the Joe McDade era that might work? And I thought about VSTACK, right? Would VSTACK work? So everything from Apple to Fig, get me A2 to A15. Everything from Apple to Fig, get me B2 to B15. And the same thing here using the helper array or just one formula. And that formula probably is not horrible. All right, so if I had to do this with a formula, I think I'm probably going to go with this VSTACK function, provided I'm on a modern Excel, Microsoft 365, and I have the VSTACK function. You could also do this with Power Query. There's a great Matt Allington video out there that I probably have stolen and put on my channel somewhere that would allow us to unwind that data in Power Query and sum it up. And so that's definitely a great way to go. I'm also curious if anyone watching has a better way, you know. And boy, I would really love a website somewhere that goes through the 500 functions in Excel and which ones actually work as 3D references and which ones don't. We know that the sum function does, and now text join and VSTACK both work. But unfortunately, filter, XLOOKUP, and SUMIFS do not. It'd be nice if there was a comprehensive list somewhere of which ones will work with 3D arrays. All right, what a great question sent in this morning by Rebaz. Thanks for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.